Hey, yo, what up, man? It's your motherfucking boy Cage in the basement, man. Motherfucking Loso versus Chef Trez. Let's talk about it, man. Hey, yo, off rip. This battle was fire, man. Real fire. And I've been waiting till the edited version came out so I could get it into some shit. But let's start it off like this. This battle was supposed to go down on Strike 2.5. You know what I mean? Unfortunate events. Your boy Trez wasn't able to show up, whatever the case may be. Salute to you. I'm glad you made it home, young man. Now we lit. Now, the reason why I mention that is this nigga Trez was different this battle, man. And I can honestly say Loso was different too. So let me not try to act like both these niggas didn't step it up, because they did, man. But let's talk about it, man. Off rip, we got Trez starting it off round one. Now, Trez a nigga that been on URL for a little minute. He done did his PG class. He done been on the URL cooking for a while. Him and Loso both come from Bullpen Battle League. So you know it's a lot of fucking fire behind this battle. Like, it's a lot of shit behind this battle. So I was fucking with it. So Trez got a lot to prove. He got a lot of steam on his chest. You know, big bro John standing right there. So he going off. And I can honestly say, Trez impressed me as a motherfucker first round. Now, Trez is nice. I'm not going to say that nigga didn't impress me before. He definitely did, but this is a different Trez. Like, he was in a whole new comfortable bag, a whole new swag. Like, I was like, all right, this the Trez where he elevating, he stepping his shit up. I'm like, damn, Loso, nigga, you fresh out the PGs, and you got to go against this? So I'm like, damn, I don't know, man. So Chef Trez round one fire. Then your boy Loso goes, and I'm like, hold up. This nigga's keeping up, like, I think Beasley said it best in the intro. The nigga got such a vocal clarity that you could clearly hear everything he's saying, and it kind of makes his shit more fire if you like that type of shit. I do, specifically. Like, I like vocal projection and vocal clarity when niggas is rhyming, so I appreciate that from Loso. So I immediately got that. I'm like, this nigga's projecting well. He's confident. He's doing his thing. He's definitely stepping it up from when I first seen him in the Scotty battle. It's like, it's a little more than just confidence now. It's like experience, scale. He incorporating a lot of good shit up there. So I was fucking around Loso round one. I ain't gonna hold you. When I first seen the battle, before I did my analytical shit, I had Loso winning round one. But then I went back and watched it. You know, I gotta do the nitpicking shit. And I'm like, Chef Trez first round was cleaner. Like, Loso had, I'm not gonna say they were stumbles or chokes or nothing crazy like that, but he had two hiccups. Now, a hiccup is where you might have to repeat one line, two lines, one word, two words over again. A stumble is like you gotta repeat a line or a whole bar, bring a whole shit back. A choke is when you just forget your shit and you gotta bring it back several times, or you go more than 10 seconds remembering shit. That's a choke. But a hiccup is when you just bring a line back because you fucked up your flow, you know, your rhythm. I don't really take away points for that, but it's still, you can't get a flawless round with a hiccup, you know what I mean? So going back on my third watch, like I always do, I kind of was edging Trez the first round. I'm like, he was more clean and he had more, you know, more. I don't count shit by punches, but what he delivered it cleaner, and with Loso hiccups, it kind of made me edge Trez the first round. But still mad debatable. Somebody want to give Loso the first round? I'm not going to argue with you, man. Your boy put on. He impressed me. Both of these niggas impressed me. Then we get into round two. And yo, off rip, I'm not going to hold you. This is when my boy Trez started wilding. Loso too, but Trez, this nigga, how he started the shit off? He was talking some different shit. Like, I can't quote all the bars these niggas had. These niggas was bar for bar. They was trying to bar for bar each other heads off, and I love that type of shit. Now, the nigga Trez was talking some shit like, nigga, you trying to collect ties, nigga. I'm trying to collect calls, nigga. Like, I can't miss this collect call. That shit was fire, nigga. Like, that shit was fire, nigga. You worrying about the good book? My niggas getting booked for good?
What?
What are you talking about, Trez? You don't know shit about that, Loso? Nah, I don't know, man, but fuck, man. Damn, man. Shit crazy. Niggas getting booked for good. Fuck the good book. No, niggas be needing a good book when they get booked for good. That's crazy. The nigga had some other shit, too, man. Like, oh, man. The best PG of your life would be the Pearly Gates, my nigga. That was foul. That nigga don't want to do that PG. Nobody don't want to do that PG, Trez. You wildin'. Like, leave that shit alone, bro. They ain't what? Come on, man. You know the nigga hype about being on home. You gonna talk about that? Come on, man. That shit was crazy, man. Yo, I ain't gonna hold you. I wrote some shit down, but I ain't gonna get into anything. Trez round two fire. And Loso comes out. I'm not gonna hold you. That boy was wildin'. That nigga Loso had so much fucking different shit in this battle, in the second round. But I kind of say he lost steam at the end. But in the beginning, I gotta give him props, man. That nigga hit the whole, a couple of schemes that had my head fucked up. Like, nah, the whole energy scheme, we gotta give that nigga more credit for that. That nigga did an energy drink scheme. Into a haymaker, into a bring it back. Back to back to back. The energy scheme alone would have been fire. Then the nigga had a haymaker to finish the punch. He punched at the end, so it kind of was a haymaker. Then when the nigga did the old twerk thinking I'm the craziest Christian. What? No, I said bow, nigga, have a conversation with him. Like, oh my God. Yo, he caught me off guard, even on a replay. I got caught off guard second watch. I was like, I still ain't see it coming. Like, damn, that was fire. I was like, yo, I forgot about that. That's crazy. So round two, but he kind of, like, he didn't have no stumbles or hiccups, but I don't think nothing he had was more fire than that in his second round. He kind of went down. So I'm kind of edging Trez the second round. I kind of giving Trez the second round. Trez was talking that shit. In the third round, Trez kind of came out the same thing, like mad comfortable, mad swagging on this nigga. Like, you couldn't tell Trez in a million years he was gonna lose this battle. Not after what he wrote, not after what he prepared. And that nigga showed that, like, he came to fucking play round three. And I think he kind of closed the battle out round three. If I was unconvinced about round one and round two, round three, I was kind of convinced. And if I'm not mistaken, Loso round three was shorter than Trez, and that don't really matter. It only matters when y'all both was fire and you just don't have enough because he got way more. And he, it's not like he went over the time crazy. It's just that he had more substance in that third. Like, Loso had substance, but I was fucking with Trez shit more, man. Trez round three, clear. So you could call this shit 3-1 Trez or 2-1 Trez. Either way you want to put it. Now I'm going to say this. Watching this battle, I definitely want to see fucking Trez again. Trez put the fuck on. We already know that. That boy Chef been cooking. But yo, Loso put on, man. This nigga Loso is ready. Like, I wasn't truly a believer in magic when I seen that Scotty shit. Scotty might have got you in that one even. But now I think you ready. But I still don't think you didn't need the PG. But you definitely ready for the main stage, them big cards. You definitely a problem out there. Do your thing. Keep putting on. And I see you try to bring A-Ward in the battle, man. I'm glad. I like that shit y'all did in the third round. That was cool. But that nigga got to do his PG too, man. Get it done, get it over with, and get in here and start killing shit. If you ain't going to do that, nobody don't want to hear nothing you talking about. All that, my accolades and my stat shit. Cry me a river with that shit, man. Do your fucking PG. Come in here and kill something, and then talk about it after that. But you already know what it is. Your boy Cage in the motherfucking basement. We live, we lit. And this is what we doing. Yeah, nigga!